In the last session, we have seen how we can create a Jenkins pipeline using a Jenkins file within a Jenkins job. Now let us see how we can get this Jenkins file from Git or any source code management system and then use it in our Jenkins job. So here, let's get started with step number one. You can create a new job or use existing job, and it should be of type pipeline, and we have already created a job of type pipeline in the earlier session. So I'm going to use that job. This is pipeline one that we created. And here, if I go to configure, you can see we have already run some of the pipelines. And if I go to configuration page of this job and go to pipeline, you can see this is what we used here. We have two options. We have pipeline as script and pipeline script from SCM. In the earlier session, we used this and we added this Jenkins file here. Now I'm going to create a Git repository. So I will say create a repository on GitHub, and you can use Bitbucket or any other cloud repository or a Git repository for this. I will go to Google and search for GitHub and go to github.com. And you can create a free account here and do a sign up. In my case, I will do a sign in. I already have an account. I will add my user and password and sign in. And I'm going to create a new repository here. You can go from here and say new repository, or just go from here and click on new. And here I have to give a repository name. I will say Jenkins pipeline demo. And you can give some description, which is optional. And you can make it public or private. I will keep it public so I do not have to add credentials, although I will show you how to add credentials in your Jenkins. And I will say create repository. So this is my Git repository on GitHub. Now the next step is, step number three will be add Jenkins file in the repository. Now inside your Git repository, you can create a file and commit it on your repository. Now you can do it from your local system and then commit it here. Just in case you want, you can watch my Git and GitHub tutorials, but for now I am going to keep it very simple. I will go and click here. So here it is, create a new file. And even if you do not get this option from here, I will show you later. As of now, I am going to click on create a new file. And here I will give the file name. Now I'm saying Jenkins file. Although you can name it anything, we will anyways have to provide the location on our Jenkins job. So I will say Jenkins file, or you can say ABC123, whatever you want. And here in this file, I want to add the script of my stages as we do in the Jenkins file, as we have done in our earlier session. So this is the declarative script, the Groovy script that we add in our Jenkins file. And I'm just going to add it here. And now I will commit this file. Now, just in case you want to add any other file, you can go from here and create a new file and add it. Now, as of now, I have added this file. So from my Jenkins, in my Jenkins job, I will now say pipeline script from SCM, and the SCM I'm going to use is Git. And this comes if you have the Git plugin added in your Jenkins. Just in case you do not see this option, you can go to manage Jenkins, manage plugin, and add the Git plugin. Now I have to give the repository URL. So this is my URL. I will click here. I can copy the URL from this address bar, or I can also copy it from here. Both will work. I will add the URL here. And now if this is a private repository, I will need to add the credentials. Otherwise I can leave it. Just in case you have to add, you can go here, click on Jenkins, and give your GitHub username. In this case, I'm using GitHub, so I will say my GitHub username, my GitHub password. If you want to give any ID, that is fine. Otherwise, it will auto-generate. And I will say my GitHub credentials here and say add. And now here, I can just add these credentials. And then I have to select the branch. So if I see on my repository, the branch that I have is called main. I'm just going to change from master to main here. And now here I have to give the script path. Now in my case, I am calling it as Jenkins file. So if this is fine, I can keep it as it is. Otherwise, if you have any other name, you can give the name here. Also, if you have your file in some folder, then you can give the folder name first. For example, you can first say whatever your folder name is and then forward slash whatever your file name is. So you can do that. Just in case you have any issues, you can always click on these question marks, which will give you the description how you have to give this field. So you, this will help you. Now this is done. I will say step number 4 is add repo and Jenkins file location on the in the job under pipeline section. Or I should say, even before this, step number 4 should be under Jenkins job pipeline section select. So we have to select here pipeline script from SCM. This is the definition. And now I should save and run. So I'm going to apply and save. And I will say build now. And let us see, we have already done 3 builds of this pipeline. And you can see the 4th build is here and everything is fine. And you can see all this is now coming from our repository. The Jenkins file is coming from the repository and now it is running. I can go and check the details in the console output. And you can see this is coming from our repository, which is here, GitHub Jenkins pipeline demo. And it is first cloning the repository. And you can also see the location where this repository is cloned. If I go to this location, I will see my Jenkins file from the repository. So if I just go to my folder and go to this location, you will see this Jenkins file has come here and then it is running all the stages that we had on our Jenkins file. And if I go back to the project and I will say build now again, and you will see the next build of this pipeline and everything is running fine. So this is how you can get a Jenkins file from Git SCM and then run the Jenkins pipeline. I hope this was useful for you. Thank you for watching.